Hello again, this is Megha and in today's video we are going to complete your chapter Journey to the End of the Earth. We have already done two parts of this chapter and in this video we will discuss part 3. So we were talking about Antarctica, the coldest, windiest and driest continent of the world. Through this lesson we came to know about how a visit to Antarctica can be an enlightening experience. A visit there can teach the next generation to understand and value our planet. It's the perfect place to study the effects that global warming is causing. It's here that one can see the effects of melting glaciers and collapsing ice shelves and how this is likely to raise the water levels in the sea and the ocean. And if global warming makes Antarctica warmer, it will have disastrous consequences elsewhere. Antarctica is a perfect place to study the effect of environmental changes as it has a very simple ecosystem and it lacks biodiversity. Now the question is, what is ecosystem and what is biodiversity? चीजों को डिस्कस करने से पहले उनके बारे में जान लेना ज़्यादा ज़रूरी होता है. बात करते हैं ecosystem की. So, an ecosystem consists of all living and non-living things in a specific natural setting. मतलब कि जितने भी living things हैं वो non-living things के साथ, non-living चीज़ों के साथ अपने एक अलग ही environment में रहते हैं. Example of ecosystem you have in the screen. Now this is the food chain of an ecosystem. To have better understanding of this, please pause the video for a few seconds. An ecosystem has many types. Now if we talk about desert ecosystem, तो वहाँ के ecosystem में हमें मिलेगा sand, rocks, insects, reptiles, plants and shrubs. ये सारे desert के ecosystem में हैं. And tundra ecosystem. In tundra ecosystem, we find snow-covered peaks, treeless and frozen soil. और यदि हम बात करें अब Antarctic के ecosystem की, तो you may guess what we can find in Antarctica. That's ice, penguins, seals, and whales, and sometimes killer whales, and phytoplankton. And here we have food chain of Antarctica ecosystem from phytoplankton to killer whale. Pause the video and watch it a bit. Okay, the second thing you must know is about biodiversity. अब ये biodiversity क्या है? इसका मतलब होता है जैव विविधता. It means the variety of plants and animal life in the world. The variety of plants and animal life in the world, a high level of which is usually considered to be important and desirable. So, अब आप लोग ये तो जान ही चुके होंगे कि अंटार्कटिका का इकोसिस्टम कितना सिंपल है और वहाँ पर बायोडायवर्सिटी ना के बराबर है. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ हर सिंपल इकोसिस्टम एंड लैक ऑफ बायोडायवर्सिटी, इट इज़ द परफेक्ट प्लेस टू स्टडी हाउ लिटिल चेंजेस इन द एनवायरनमेंट कैन हैव बिग इफेक्ट्स. नाउ द राइटर इज गिविंग द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फाइटोप्लैंक्टन, द माइक्रोस्कोपिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स that live in watery environment both salty and fresh. आसान शब्दों में कहा जाए तो phytoplankton वो microscopic plants हैं जो watery environment में रहते हैं. And it comes first in the food chain of Antarctica ecosystem. And like land plants, phytoplankton have chlorophyll to capture sunlight. And they use photosynthesis to turn it into chemical energy. जैसे land plants होते हैं वैसे ही phytoplankton होता है. फ़र्क ये है कि phytoplankton microscopic होते हैं और पानी के अंदर होते हैं या फिर watery environment में होते हैं. अब जो ये phytoplankton है, these are the foundation of the aquatic food web. Aquatic food web phytoplankton से ही start होता है. Small fish and invertebrates also graze on the plant-like organisms, means phytoplankton, and then those smaller animals are eaten by bigger ones. And scientists warn that a further depletion in the ozone layer will affect the activities of phytoplankton. which in turn will affect the lives of all the marine animals and birds of the region and the global carbon cycle. कि यदि फाइटोप्लैंकटन की एक्टिविटीज़ पे असर पड़ता है तो क्या होगा कि जितने भी मैरीन लाइफ है, मैरीन एनिमल्स है, एक्वेटिक एनिमल्स है, उनकी उनको भी बुरी तरीके से ये चीज़ें असर करेगी, क्योंकि फाइटोप्लैंकटन से ही उनकी फूड चेन स्टार्ट हो रही है. नाउ हियर वी हैव अ स्टेटमेंट, टेक केयर ऑफ स्मॉल थिंग्स एंड द बिग थिंग्स विल टेक केयर ऑफ देमसेल्व्स. दीज माइक्रोस्कोपिक ग्रासेस phytoplankton, these undergo the process of photosynthesis and serve as food for number of marine birds and animals. So if we take care, that process carried over by these small grasses are carried out properly, the bigger animals and birds will fall into the place of their own. This statement is quite relevant. A small change in the environment can give rise to drastic developments. Nature is all about take care of the small things and big things will take care of themselves. The writer says that underneath our feet was a meter thick ice pack and underneath that 180 meters of living breathing salt water. What? Salt water? And that too underneath the ice pack? A sea of salt water under Antarctica? Okay, let me explain. The surface waters of the Arctic and Antarctic become very cold and finally freeze. When sea water freezes to form sea ice, salt is squeezed out and moves down to water. This means that the sea ice is made up of mostly fresh water and the water just below the sea ice is saltier and more dense. And experiencing such experience and watching the seals stretching themselves on floating ice made the writer realize that everything does connect. From Madras to Antarctica, the writer had to cross the 9 time zones, 6 checkpoints and 3 bodies of water, means 3 oceans. And the author pondered upon the capability of nature to maintain its balance. And she wondered what it would be like if Antarctica, the place that houses over 90% of world's ice, becomes warm again. And she wonders if we will be there to see it, if it ever happens. But who knows? And after spending 2 weeks with a bunch of teenagers who still have the idealism and courage to save the world, the writer talks about the uncertainty of events that can happen over a million years. In this way, it will also suggest a lot of future possibilities. Probably for even a million years later. यदि अब सभी चीज़ों को समराइज किया जाए, आज तक हमने जितना भी पढ़ा है तो ये समरी कुछ इस तरीके से होगी. अंटार्कटिका का जो विजिट है, इट विल हेल्प अस टू अंडरस्टैंड वेयर वी हैव कम फ्रॉम, मीन्स आर पास्ट, एंड वेयर वी कुड पॉसिबली बी हेडिंग, हम कहाँ को जा रहे हैं, हमारा फ्यूचर. And by visiting the Antarctica, we get an opportunity to study about the future climatic changes more easily and more effectively. We also come to know about the repercussion of the various environmental changes. It also gives us the realization of the appearance of the future world. Future world. यदि हम अवेयर रहे तो नेचुरल बैलेंस बना रहेगा, अदरवाइज अंटार्कटिका विल गेट वार्म और कुछ भी हो सकता है. द आइस कोर्स ऑफ अंटार्कटिका होल्ड मोर देन 500,000 ईयर ओल्ड कार्बन रिकॉर्ड्स विच आर वेरी क्रूशियल फॉर द स्टडी ऑफ पास्ट, प्रेजेंट एंड फ्यूचर ऑफ द प्लैनेट. आई होप कि आपको कार्बन रिकॉर्ड्स की बातें याद रही होगी. All this will also help us to understand our planet better and also give us ideas to save our planet. The Journey to the End of the Earth is a very wonderful chapter. It gives us an insight into the fact that we cannot feel the impact of the environment sitting in our living room. But when we step in Antarctica, we understand its reality to the fullest. Because there you see the impact of global warming right in front of your eyes. Students, Earth is the only planet to have life. Save the Earth. Without Earth, no one will take birth. And if you destroy the Earth, you destroy the chance of life. Save Earth to continue living here. With this, I end my chapter here. Goodbye, Khuda Hafiz, Sayonara, and Jai Hind.